Welcome to the Audio Renaissance unabridged presentation of How to Become a Rainmaker. Written by Jeffrey J. Fox. Produced by Tony Hunts. And now, here is Jeffrey J. Fox.
Hello. Let's start with the introduction. You should listen to this program if your organization needs revenues. American Indian tradition exalts the rainmaker. The rainmaker used magical powers to bring the rain, to nourish the crops, to feed the people. Without the rain, the people would weaken, die, or have to move elsewhere. Today, a rainmaker is a person who brings revenue into an organization, be it profit or not-for-profit. That revenue comes from customers and donors. That revenue is the aqua viva, the lifeblood of the organization. Without it, the organization will die. Customers' money is the rain. The term rainmaker is more commonly used in such professional service industries as legal, accounting, consulting, investment banking, advertising, and architecture. In these industries, rainmakers are the two or so people in the firm who are responsible for generating most of the new customers, the new business. Big-hitting rainmakers are among the highest-paid employees in every company in every industry. They operate under many titles: owner, partner, chancellor, sales representative, CEO, agent, managing director, and fundraiser. If becoming a rainmaker is your goal, then this program will help you get there. There is another kind of rainmaker, and he or she is an employee, or associate, or colleague, or team member, or crew member. Every employee must be somehow involved in the identification, attraction, getting, and keeping of customers. The advice in this program tilts to the salesperson, but if you have contact with customers, or work with and support colleagues who have contact with customers, this program will make you more effective. You will be better able to sell inside, to sell your ideas to your organization. The most important success factor in any business or organization is having a customer. This is more important than the business idea, the products, the machinery, the buildings, the financing, or the people. It is customer money that pays everyone's salary, that pays for 401k plans, union dues, bonuses, vacations, health insurance, computers, and office furniture. Customers are known by many names: members, students, fans, soldiers, parishioners, and patients. Regardless of what they are called, without customers, no organization can continue to survive. Therefore, the paramount job of every single employee in an organization is to, directly or indirectly, get and keep customers. This is true without exception. The job of every employee is to help ring the cash register. The job of every employee is to keep the customers coming and to keep the customers coming back. This program is a recipe for how to sell, for how to make rain, be it drizzle or deluge, sprinkle or storm. If your organization needs revenues, and if you want to become invaluable to your organization, then listen closely. Now let's begin with Chapter 1, The Rainmaker's Credo. Cherish customers at all times. Treat customers as you would your best friend. Listen to customers and decipher their needs. Make or give customers what they need. Price your product to its dollarized value. Show customers the dollarized value of what they will get. Teach customers to want what they need. Make your product the way customers want it. Get your product to your customers when they want it. Give your customers a little extra, more than they expect. Remind customers of the dollarized value they received. Thank each customer sincerely and often. Help customers pay you, so they won't be embarrassed and go elsewhere. Ask to do it again. Chapter 2. Always answer the question, why should this customer do business with us? Never make a sales call on a customer unless you can answer the question, why should this customer do business with our company or with me? The answer must be of benefit to the customer. The answer must fit the customer's agenda, not yours. The customer should do business with you because you will make him feel good, or you will solve his problem, or both. There must be a business benefit and a personal benefit, often interlinked, for the customer. For example, a business benefit might be getting a new product to market sooner, thereby generating millions of dollars in new sales. The personal benefit might be a job promotion for the customer. If the benefit makes the customer feel good, then, for example, the effective furnace or natural gas salesperson's answer might be, the customer will get warm, cozy rooms. By the way, the ineffective furnace salesperson thinks the customer is buying BTUs. If your product solves a problem, then the answer to the question should be phrased in dollars and cents. For example, assume a software program enables a hotel to more accurately capture and bill any computer usage of hotel phone lines. If that's the case, the reason the customer should do business with you is because your product will generate $2 per room per night in incremental revenue. The Rainmaker answers the question, why should the customer do business with us? By calculating what economic benefits the product will give the customer and by calculating the consequences to the customer of not going with the recommended product. The Rainmaker determines how the customer is benefited directly and personally. The Rainmaker puts himself or herself in the customer's shoes and answers the question, if I were the customer, how would this product benefit me? Chapter 3. Obey Marketing's First Commandment. The first commandment of getting and keeping customers is to treat each customer as you would treat yourself. Do you like to be overcharged, underserved, put on endless hold, overbooked, told your room isn't ready, falsely promised, shipped late, ignored, not thanked? Always put yourself in the shoes of the good customer. Answer the question, what would I want if I were the customer? The answer is what you should strive to provide. This is important when dealing with the upset customer. When you are the upset customer, you want a full, uninterrupted hearing. You want to deal with someone with the authority to fix the problem, and you want a fair resolution. You don't want to be sent a copy of the company's warranty policy. You don't want to be told to send another sample of your upholstery to the factory, get yet another professional couch cleaning, or be told the stains are of, quote, indeterminate nature, unquote, and your claim is denied. Remember, good customers are demanding. They may expect more from you than you believe is appropriate. What you want or how you want to be treated may not be good enough to satisfy your customers, but it's a good starting place. Deliver on your promise, and you will bring rain. Chapter 4. Customers don't care about you. In the selling arena, customers don't care if you have a mortgage to pay. Customers don't care if you need their business to win a contest. Customers don't care why your shipments are late. Customers don't care what you like, where you went to school, or what sports you play or played. The only thing customers care about are themselves and their problem. You are in front of the customer only because the customer believes, if only a little bit, that you might be able to better his or her situation. You are there by invitation only. You must concentrate on the customer. You must be on high receive. You do not talk about yourself. Rather, you ask probing, pre-planned questions. You listen to what the customer says. Clarify. Summarize. Determine how you can help the customer and how your product solves the customer's concern. Rainmakers say you. They don't say I. Chapter 5. Always pre-call plan every sales call. Appointments with decision makers are relatively rare events. Meetings with decision makers are crucial to getting the sale. Because of this, meetings with a decision maker must be carefully pre-planned. Pre-call planning is particularly important when making the first call on a new customer and when making the last call, the one that concludes with an order. 90% of all sales calls are won or lost before the salesperson sees the customer. This is because so few salespeople actually plan the call. Too many salespeople believe experience is a substitute for pre-call planning. They think they don't need to. Other salespeople do their pre-call planning on the way to a call. Others don't even know how to pre-call plan. Some don't know they should. Rainmakers never waste a sales call. They always pre-call plan. It is typical for a Rainmaker to spend 3 hours planning for a 15-minute sales call. Planning and practicing for 2 days to 2 weeks for a single sales call is not uncommon. One Rainmaker spent 15 straight 8-hour days researching and planning a 15-minute sales call. The call was on the CEO of a leading company in a new industry. If this company adopted the Rainmaker's product, almost certainly the other companies in the industry would follow. The Rainmaker made the sale and successfully used it as a case history to close other customers. This single sale saved the Rainmaker's company and led to years of success. NFL coaches spend countless hours reviewing game films in preparation for their next opponent. It is said of Joe Paterno, the heralded head coach of the Penn State football team, that if he is given 2 weeks to develop a game plan, his team is nearly invincible. A pre-call plan for a Rainmaker is like a pre-flight check for an airplane pilot. The great pilots never miss a single checkpoint before taking off or landing. If a pilot misses something, that pilot may be missing. If a salesperson misses something, the order may be missing. What should a pre-call planning checklist include? 1. A written sales call objective. 2. Needs analysis questions to ask. 3. Something to show. 4. Anticipated customer concerns and objections. 5. Points of difference vis-a-vis competitors. 6. Meaningful benefits to customers. 7. Dollarization approach, investment return analysis. 8. Strategies to handle objections and eliminate customer concerns. 9. Closing strategies. 10. Expect surprises. And plan to be flexible. If, after 60 seconds into your 2-hour painstakingly prepared presentation, the customer says she will buy, stop talking, take the order, and gracefully leave. If the customer wants to do business with you, but in an entirely different manner than you expected, adjust to the change. Don't be so intent on following your plan that you miss a customer's cue. Be flexible. A Rainmaker never calls on a decision maker without a written pre-call plan. Chapter 6, Fish Where the Big Fish Are. When asked, what is the most important thing you need when you go fishing? Most people say bait, pole, hooks, and beer. Those are important, but the most important thing needed is fish. You can have the best boat on the prettiest lake with awesome tackle, but if there are no fish, you will go home empty-handed. If, however, you have only a raggedy old net but a little pond teeming with fish, your chances of a catch are much greater. Where you cast your line is crucial to catching fish. This is also true for selling. Rainmakers fish where the big fish are. Rainmakers talk to customers who are familiar with their product, or who already use the product, or who have a high probability of using the product. Don't waste your time trying to convince dairy farmers to buy horseshoes, and don't waste your time selling hospital beds to hotels. Big companies in an industry are generally better prospects than small companies in the same industry.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.